Find out what your neighbors and friends are talking about on AM 750 WSB and the Ludlow Porch Talk Show. The lines are open for you at 872-0750. Now, more fun with Ludlow Porch.
Well, welcome back, gang. 6 minutes after 10 o'clock at AM 750 WSB, Ludlow Porch, and as promised, my buddy is here. It has been a long time since we have been able to sit down and share a microphone, talked on the telephone a lot of times, but a long time. And it would be almost foolhardy for me to sit here and tell you about the accomplishments of my friend Jerry Clower. Just let me tell you this, that he is probably the most beloved humorist in the United States of America. And I will guarantee you that I can prove this. He is one of the best men and one of the nicest men. And let me just tell you... One Jerry Clower quote, and then I will introduce him and let you talk to him. Jerry Clower said, "I am convinced that there's only one place where there's no laughter, and that's hell." He says, "I have made arrangements to miss hell. Praise God, I won't ever have to be anywhere that there ain't no laughter." Here, here. Jerry Clower, welcome, old friend. How you doing?
Oh, shoot this thing! Ludlow!
How you doing?
I love you. I love to be with a man that's hip and stamp out negativism.
All right, good for you.
And I'm on your side. I love a man that ain't never seen a sunrise or a frost. The sun's always high enough to get the frost off the ground before he gets up.
That's right.
You are a heavyweight, and it's... I landed at the airport, and Delta folks said, "Yeah, Jerry, what you doing in town? I'm going to sit in with Ludlow." Well, everybody, "Hey, what time?" So you stout and you strong, and it's I don't dread some things that I have to do, because I'm like the Apostle Paul. Whatsoever state I'm in, I'm content, and I go ahead and do it. But there's some places I go and some things I do that I don't look forward to doing as much as I would other places. I don't know of any place I'd rather be than on WSB AM 750 with Ludlow Porch.
Bless your heart. Well, we have been looking forward to this. As a matter of fact, I want to tell you a true story now. I got all the information on you from our mutual friend Tandy.
Yes.
And I was so anxious to have you on that on October 27th, I cut some promos, said Jerry Clower going to be here tomorrow. and then when I walked in, he sat down, I was a month early, but they all ran. So you folks been looking forward to you being here for a long time.
Well, that's great.
Listen, I got a bunch of questions, but I have two things I want to get out of the way. That you are a brand new granddad. You got a...
Yes. My fourth grandchild was born at Columbus, Mississippi, to Ken and Sue Hall. Sue is my third child. She's my daughter, and I love her. Her husband is Ken Hall. He is the director of missions, student missions. He's minister of students at the First Baptist Church of Columbus, Mississippi. They got a little boy, 2 foot long, and weighs 9 pounds, and his name is, me and you'd have named him, we wouldn't have named him this, but they named him Kenneth Payne Hall. Now, he's going to fight his way through the first 5 grades at school, because you know what kind of pain they're going to say he is. Yeah. But that's what they've done. And I am a new granddaddy. That makes me 4.
All right. And plus, if I'm not badly mistaken, tomorrow's your birthday.
Tomorrow's my birthday. Yes, sir. Early one frosty morn down in Dixie, I was born.
So we wish you a happy birthday.
Oh, you very kind. Thank you, sir.
Let's get right in here to our telephones. We've got some folks been holding on a long time to talk to you. We're going to talk to Carl. Carl, you're on with Jerry Clower.
Jerry Clower, how you doing?
Wonderful, Carl. How you?
Oh, I'm pretty good. Do you operate out of Nashville?
Yes, sir. My agency is in Nashville, but I live at Route 4, Liberty, Mississippi.
Now, Liberty is how far from Memphis?
Liberty is a 5-hour drive from Memphis, Tennessee, straight down Interstate 55. I live 60 miles due north of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, right in the edge of Mississippi.
Well, you almost live in New Orleans, then.
Well, 118 miles.
Jerry, I have a question.
Yes, sir.
I have a son that fancies himself a country music writer.
Yes, sir.
And he went to Nashville last Saturday for this. It seems that on Saturday, the people like yourself, probably a whole lot less important than you, gather and listen to these new songwriters.
Yes, sir.
That can write. Are you familiar with that Saturday night operation?
I have heard about it.
I see. I have mixed emotions. I kind of hope he's successful, and yet he makes a good living in another field. And
yes, sir.
I wonder if he should be successful and think he could make a living writing music. And
how old is he?
Have one song and never have another one.
How old is he?
Well, he is 30-some years
old. Okay. Well, I don't worry about if he was a child. I'd say go get him in the throat and drag him home and say and beat Nashville out of his head. But if he's a grown adult man and he wants to write songs on the side and have a hit or two, don't you worry about him. He's going to be all right. Them folks in Nashville are honest people. They got all these copyright laws and all this stuff, and they'll take care of him. And who knows, he may write one song and that would be enough.
Well, of course, he's hoping to make a whole lot of money, but
yeah.
I'm kind of like you. I would like to grab him by the throat and bring him home, but he's too damn big and too strong.
That's right. Well, let him have his fling, but tell him don't give up his regular job.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Carl, let me leave you with a truism. This will help you when you think about this at night. Creative people are only happy when they're creating, so don't get in his way.
That's right.
You there, Carl?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, buddy.
Man.
I appreciate that piece of advice.
Thank you, sir.
We're going to Jackson, Mississippi, and talk to the Kennesaw Kid from Jackson, Mississippi.
Oh.
You on with Jerry Clower.
Hey, Ludlow.
Hi, buddy.
Hey, brother Jerry.
Hey, man.
I'm from over around Atlanta area, and I was listening to Ludlow yesterday that you was going to be on here. And it's fitting I get to go to Jackson, Mississippi.
Well, ain't that nice?
And got up this morning, I wanted to call you, and I just want to let you know that you don't know how many truck drivers at night you keep awake.
Well,
midnight. 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, you get tired and sleepy. I got all your tapes. I pop them in the cassette.
I love you more than them. It ain't got all of them.
It keeps us awake here.
Yeah.
You just don't know what you do for us.
Well, you're very kind, and I appreciate you calling, man. You something else. Make me feel good.
Yes, sir. It's 52 degrees in Jackson, Mississippi.
Ooh, if I was over there, I'd get my cotton sack. I could pick about 350 today.
Uh-huh. Let alone you take care of him.
All right, my man. You take care of yourself.
All right, buddy.
Talk to you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bubba, you're on AM 750 WSB with Jerry Clower.
Hey, Bubba.
This is Bubba Eubanks, your cousin up in Woodstock.
Oh, I love you, Bubba. Bless you.
I got to tell you something real quick.
All
years
right.
ago, I was listening to one of your tapes.
Yeah.
And you were saying something on the order of that it wouldn't hurt maybe Jerry Clower's to have one little drink. But if one of your fans saw you and they couldn't handle it, and they got in trouble over it, that the good book was clear that it'd be your fault, so you just leave it alone altogether.
Yeah.
I've told that to so many people, and I believe it's touched a lot of lives.
Well, you're very kind. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, and God bless you.
Call Orlando Wilson when you get off the phone and tell him that I still love him, even though I can catch perch better than him.
Do you ever see Jack Eubanks up in Nashville?
No, I don't believe.
Yeah. Next time you're up that way, he's still picking and grinning. He's one of the local boys that made it big back with Leroy Van Dyke.
Oh, hey, I know who you're talking about.
Yeah,
sure.
That's Uncle Jack.
Okay, man.
Have a good one.
Bless you.
Take care. 872-0750. It is 10:15. Our special guest is Jerry Clower. Stay with us. All right. It is 19 minutes now to 10 o'clock, and we're chatting with Jerry Clower on AM 750 WSB. If you'd like to talk to Jerry, we have waived the four-day rule, so you can, even if you've already called today or called yesterday. Let's get right to our phones and talk to Gene. Gene, you're on with Jerry Clower.
Hey, Luddy.
Hey, dear.
Jerry, I got a story for you.
Hi, Gene.
When your first album came out, it also came out in 8-track. I think you remember a long time ago.
Yes, ma'am.
I have some logging friends that live in northern Idaho.
Yeah.
And at the time, it had not come out up there, and I sent them an 8-track of that first one.
Yes, ma'am.
And she didn't bother to write me back. She called me long distance to tell me her husband was rolling in the floor over Marcel's chainsaw.
Amen.
He He said that was, without a doubt, the funniest thing he had ever heard in his
life. Well, that's lovely. I'm glad to hear
he
that.
Was
maybe
that long, that far back, and I still hear from him, and he still loves Marcel's Chainsaw. He had been logging all and lived, born and raised in northern Idaho, and knew what logging was and knew what a chainsaw was. And knew what a chainsaw could do to a screen door.
That's wonderful. Maybe they'll play that cut and run that spotted owl out of that country where they can go ahead and cut that timber.
Oh, Lord. Woody Duck could have a fit with you.
Well, darling, you're very kind. I thank you for calling and
I've always wanted to talk to you, but never got the chance.
Well,
this time I got on the phone with you before 10 o'clock.
You did good, Gene.
Keep listening to Ludlow.
I sure do, every day. Every day.
Take care of yourself.
He calls me Blue Jean. Bye-bye.
Talk to you, Blue Jean.
All right.
Bye-bye. We're going out to Dallas, Georgia, and talk to another one of my favorite folks, the Choo-Choo Man. Choo-Choo, you're on with Jerry Clower.
Ludlow.
How you doing?
Boy, Luddy, this Choo-Choo Man in beautiful downtown Dallas, Georgia, is just busting at the seams to say hello to Jerry Clower.
Hey, Choo-Choo, how you doing?
Jerry, I'm doing fine, and I hope you are.
I felt any better, I'd have to be a twin.
You are sounding good.
Thank you.
You're sounding good over this way, and doggone, we're just tickled to death to have you on the Ludlow Porch Show.
Thank you, sir. Me and Ludlow Porch, we two of a kind that can whoop a full house.
I know that's right. Listen, did you bring Marcel with you?
No, sir, but I can send and get him. I've been talking to Marcel. He bought an interest in a racehorse. Him and his old Putwood buddies bought him a horse. And last Saturday, they took the horse to Faraday, Louisiana, and raced him. Well, I was doing the Virginia State Fair at Richmond, and I couldn't get down there. So a Sunday morning, I called Marcel. I said, did your horse win? He said, no, but it took six of them to whoop him.
Doggone, I was hoping Marcel would be with you because I believe old Marcel would fit right into Ludlow Porch's whackos.
Well, he would, and Marcel loves Ludlow Porch. He drives a truck through here occasionally and listens to him.
I know. And listen, I'm going to get off of here and let somebody else jump in here and talk to you. Have a good day.
Before you go, Choo-Choo, I want to tell Jerry that this man we're talking to, Jerry, knows more about country music, I'm talking about back in the 20s till today, than anybody I know. He is my source for country music.
Great.
Yeah, I pulled a good one. I got him on a trivia just Tuesday, wasn't it, Luddy?
Wore me out. Wore me out.
You have a good day.
Thank you, sir.
See you later.
Talk to you, Choo-Choo.
Enjoy it.
872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK. And we have some very distinguished visitors with us here, going through the the folk, Mary Hart from Mara, Georgia. And you can look at that crowd and tell they all got Mary Harts. And we're glad you're with us. When I first saw those ladies, I thought the Falcons were holding cheerleader trials.
Yeah, that's right. They're from Mara.
Mara, Georgia.
Mara,
that's
Georgia. Right, yeah. I saw them. Their hair is getting the color of mine. Some of them,
must be something in the air.
But they fine, pretty ladies. They smell good, too. The Avon woman's been calling on them.
Let's get back to our phones now. Quickly talk to Hobo Bill. Bill, you're on with Jerry Clower.
Good morning, Ludlow.
Hello, Bill, from Dawson, from Douglasville.
Right.
Yeah.
Hello, Jerry.
Hey, Hobo.
How you doing?
I love you, and I'm doing good.
Well, good. I've got something I want to do for you.
All right.
Happy birthday to you.
Okay.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Jerry Clower. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. You the first one that done it. I appreciate it.
Well, we love you.
Thank you.
And my whole family. I got 27 in my family, and they just love you to death.
And they call you Hobo.
Yeah, well, I taken a hobo trip one time that didn't pan out too well, so.
I asked Boxcar Willie one time what was the difference between a hobo and a bum. You don't take a shot at what he told me, Ludlow?
Well, I'd say that a bum is one that stays on the hobo, and a hobo is the one that got sense enough to get off.
What about it, Ludlow?
I would think a hobo moves around.
A hobo moves around, but he'll come up to your house and say, you got any work I can do for my supper? And a bum tries to mooch. and Boxcar Willie, he's a good one.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Hobo.
Thank you, and you have a real good one. And Rob Long,
yes, sir.
I'm so glad you had him on your program and I get to talk to him.
Always good to talk to you, Bill. Take care of yourself.
Do the same.
Bye-bye, buddy. Bye-bye. Kathy, you're on with Jerry Clower.
Hi, Jerry.
Hey, Kathy.
I just wanted to say hello because I'm from your part of the country.
Where are you from, darling?
Macomb, Mississippi.
Macomb?
Absolutely. Huh. I just sent relatives back that went back to Macomb yesterday en route to Liberty.
What's your daddy's last name?
Well, I don't know if he'd want me to say on the radio, but he is an ex-railroad man, last name of Hale, H-A-L-E.
Well, you'd have told me what his name was, I'd have told you he worked for the railroad. That's why I was wanting to know his name.
That's it, and we have friends out there in Liberty, and we're just proud as punch to call you ours.
Well, thank you, darling. I'm glad. You know, Mississippi, any Mississippian that ever left that state made an agreement that if we ever fought the federal government, that all come back and help us fight.
Oh, absolutely.
So keep your ear to the Ludlow Port Show. We're going to make the announcement through him if we ever fight the feds again.
We stick together, don't we?
Oh, we sure do, darling. And it's good to hear your voice.
We'll love you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Take care of yourself. Bye-bye. 872-0750. And here's our most famous pulpwooder. Here's Radiator. Here's a pulpwooder. Ray.
Uh-huh, Dave.
How you doing, Ray?
Well, I'm fine.
Well, you've got about a minute to talk to Jerry Clower.
Jerry Clower.
Hey, Ray, I got a son named Ray. Talk to me.
Thinks that you hung the moon.
Amen.
She's a pulp porter.
Is she?
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, she's field dressed about 285.
Yeah.
And she's been pulp wooding for about 15 years.
That's good.
And she thinks ain't nothing like Jerry.
Ray, hang on a second. I got to clear this line up. Don't go away now.
All right.
I'm going to put you right back here, put him on hold, and then... Now, let's see if I did any better than that, Ray.
How about that?
Now we got rid of that back
okay,
field.
Ray, you're doing good.
Man, then I'm calling you on my cellular phone in the pulpwood truck.
Yeah, well, I love it. You know, I'm a pilot. Marcel Ledbetter cut the pulpwood, and
yeah.
I piled it.
Yeah, and you piled it.
I'm a pilot.
Ender does that with a plate of food.
Yeah, well, that's good.
Well, look here, Jerry. I got all your albums, and ain't nothing like you.
Well, you fine, and you the heartbeat of America. I wish you was on the president's cabinet. You could get some of your views up there with them folks. And,
yeah, me and Andrew could straight that whole mess out of
Well, you could lock the door and say, hey.
That's right.
Come to some kind of decision on the budget or we ain't leaving from
That's
here.
Right.
It ain't complicated.
Yeah. See,
okay, man.
All right. Well, take care of yourself, Jerry.
Bye-bye.
Talk to you, Ray. Bye. Hang in there, buddy.
Yeah, go. You got to say the pub with business.
All right. Bell South Mobility customers can now call our talk show. Traffic, it is 10:30, and with a quick update, here is who's in our newsroom.
Kim Peterson.
Kim Peterson, tell us about the news, partner.
Thank you, Lotto. Good morning. Just in as we speak, there's a report right now in San Francisco that hostage siege in Berkeley, California may be over. Apparently, police have shot the gunman and freed the hostages. That's coming in as we speak now. It was apparently an Iranian man in his 30s who was angry he didn't get a student loan. He was holding about a dozen people for hours, shot and killed one of them, and also wounded a cop. A DeKalb County police woman is in stable condition this morning after she surprised some car thieves at her apartment complex and opened fire, wounding her in the face and side. Iraq is backing down from reported threats to hang Americans or other Westerners who are hiding foreigners in Iraq and Kuwait. The FDIC is boosting the fees it charges to commercial banks to ensure their depositors the fund could be wiped out if there's a recession. Oil prices are falling on some world markets after President Bush's decision to dip into the American oil reserves. The American Gas Association says there should be plenty of natural gas to heat your homes this winter. Police will destroy a full-grown Malamute dog who is always very protective of his family's four-week-old baby girl. But yesterday, the dog attacked and mauled the baby to death. A study shows American doctors charge 2.5 times as much as doctors in Canada, and American MDs give less service to fewer people. Pro football player Zeke Moad of the New England Patriots faces fines and suspension after he exposed himself in the locker room to a female reporter and made some obvious but obscene suggestions. And just in, WSB's Dave Folk is joining us now. Report possible fire somewhere in North Georgia, Dave?
It's at the town square in Lafayette, Georgia. That's the county seat of Walker County, Kim, up in North Georgia near the Georgia-Tennessee line. 7 businesses on the town square have burned. It started about 7:20 this morning at a Radio Shack store and has burned several of the businesses on the downtown square in Lafayette, Georgia. That's in the northern part of the state.
Any word of any injuries or what happened?
Nobody hurt so far. They don't know how it started. fire companies from all over the surrounding counties in North Georgia helping contain it right now. Still out of control, but they say it looks better than it did a few minutes ago.
Anyway. Okay, appreciate Dave Folk with the update. It's 10:32 at AM 750 WSB, the only station with our own helicopter and airplane. Depend on Skycopter Skyplane traffic. Now, Atlanta's most accurate weather with WSB meteorologist Kirk Mellish.
Saudi Arabia today, highs 101, lows 68. The WSB exclusive five-day forecast. Bright blue sky and warmer today, high 85. Tonight, clear and less cool, low 61. Tomorrow, sunshine and warm, high 86, low 64. In the extended forecast for your weekend, partly cloudy, highs 81 to 85, lows near 64. I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
At 10:33, the temperature on Peachtree Street is 71 degrees. I'm Kim Peterson, and if news breaks out, we break in. This is AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
It's time for fun and interesting conversation with Ludlow Porch on AM 750 WSB. The lines are open for you at 872-0750. That's 872-0750. Here's Ludlow Porch.
All right. Welcome back, gang. 10:33 at AM 750. Ludlow Porch, and we're talking to the undisputed king of country comedy, Jerry Clower. And, Jerry, you were telling me something about, I don't know, can we tell it on radio about the... What the survey they made of the truck stops?
Yeah,
I'd like you to tell it.
Well, it's appropriate for me to talk about it sitting right here because Southeastern Tapes at Duluth, Georgia, their expertise is to sell cassettes and home videos through truck stops on interstates in the United States. They took a little, went to the computer and asked the computer who's the best selling artist at truck stops, and I come in the top five. So then they took a poll and asked the trucker, said, you have bought a Jerry Clower cassette? Said, yeah. Said, why? Said, well, I can take it home, play it to the whole family. And them others, you can't. You got to sneak it around where the children won't hear it.
Put it in the safe.
And so Mr. Arnoff, Southeastern Tapes, called MCA and said, hey, we're going to put on a promotion, Clean Humor, selling Jerry Clower. We want 100,000 cassettes. And the MCA said, hey, wait a minute. If you're going to do that, we'll fly down there and give you a special design, and we'll make you a volume 1 through 15, best of Jerry Clower. Well, if you're going to do that, send me 200,000. And Ludlow, Southeastern Tapes at Duluth, Georgia, sold 300,000 of my cassettes in 90 days just by saying it was for family and you could play it in church. So, I have 20 albums on MCA. Each and every one are active. MCA just told me that I have more catalog and more product selling than any other artist on MCA. MCA is one of the most prestigious record companies in the world.
Oh, no question.
This makes me feel real good. That includes Elton John and folks like that. So what I'm trying to say is it don't take no talent to tell a nasty joke. I found that out fighting a war 40-some-odd years ago.
872-0750. Let's talk to M.M. Hello, M.M.
Hello. I am just delighted and honored.
Well, I know you're a right hard lady to delight, too, so we're glad you're with us.
Hey, darling. How
well,
you?
I live in Mara, same place those Merry Hearts are from.
Yeah, and this is a fine-looking bunch, darling. You pretty as them?
Well, I hope I look half as good as they do.
Yeah, boy.
But I grew up in Meridian.
Oh, do it. Lauderdale County,
absolutely.
Ludlow.
Absolutely, yeah. You know, I know why so many funny people live in Mississippi, because they got such funny names over there.
Yeah.
So-so and why not?
Yeah.
All those funniest girl I want
to see. Hot coffee.
Yeah. I went to school with a girl down there in Hattiesburg at Southern. She was from Osaka, and that was the funniest girl I've ever known in my life.
Yeah, well, Osaka's about 20 minutes from where I live, and my wife went to Southern.
Oh, did she?
Yes, Southern is the team that kicked the field goal, and the football hit the crossbar, and Ludlow Porch could come out from under the oxygen tent.
Exactly.
Whenever the ball hit the crossbar and come back, Ludlow said, I think I can make it now without no oxygen.
Let me tell you why I'd like to kill me.
Yeah.
Because up to that point,
I was convinced that the Lord had took that Saturday off and was not at Sanford Stadium. When I hit that crossbar, I said, he's here.
Yeah, well, darling.
They walked all over old Alabama, too, didn't they?
Yes, darling.
I wanted to tell you about something, and we have some retired friends that live down at Lake Sinclair, and we go down there to visit them quite frequently.
Yes.
And sometimes we take the right fork of the road and go one way on Highway 212 and just a few miles inside of that little fork in the road.
Yes.
There's a sign on the side of the road at this little farm place, and it's got a big sign out there in front of it, East Fork Ranch. And we think about Jerry Clark
every time
we pass by there, and a lot of times we'll have one of your cassettes playing.
Well, that's great. See, I grew up at East Fork Community.
I know it.
Because it's on the East Fork of Amit River, Ludlow.
Yeah.
Amit River comes running down through Amit County, and it forks. One goes east, one goes west. It comes back together down in Louisiana, and it's called the Amit River down there.
They don't know how to say it.
But up where I am, it's Amit. Now, Osaka, Mississippi, darling.
Yeah.
You brought that up.
Uh-huh.
One of the top preachers in all the world growed up there.
Who was that?
Nelson Price. First Baptist, Roswell Street Baptist Church, Marietta, Georgia.
Oh,
God bless you, Nelson Price, wherever you are.
Well, now, I got one more question.
All right, Chuck.
Ask you. Have I not heard you talk about a buddy or an acquaintance from time to time by the name of Dog Owens?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
He was teaching when I was in high school. Right?
Yeah. Yes, and he coached at Meridian.
That's right, yeah. He was coaching and teaching.
Ludlow Porch would love Dog Owens like
sure
a brother.
Would. Yeah, yeah.
Dog Owens is our kind of people. He played football with me in Mississippi State, and he growed up poor.
Yeah.
And he coached high school, and his old deep, rural, southern gentleman philosophy. And Ludlow, I'll tell you why you'd love him. His job when he was line coach at Mississippi State was to go by and pick up the mail and bring it to the office where, and then he would go on to his desk. Well, one morning he come in. Paul Davis was head coach.
Mm-hmm.
And you being a trivia expert, I don't have to tell you who Paul Davis is, thank God. Paul Davis was head coach at Mississippi State. Dog Owens come walking in and throwed the mail down. He said, oh, Lord. He said, Dog, what's the matter? He said, the students are hanging Coach Davis in jeopardy. Thank you, lady.
Yes, thank you.
I'll talk to you, my friend.
Bye.
Hang in there. 872-0750. 1-800-WSB-TALK.
Same. 40. Carswell intercepted. Carswell saved our Franny. And the Dogs will have the ball on the 40.
All right, it is 10:43 now at AM 750 WSB. Ludlow Porch, and we're talking to one of my favorite folks in the world, Jerry Clower. We'd like to have you join us. 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK. Get right to our phones and talk to Joe. Joe, you're on with Jerry Clower.
It's a pleasure to hear two great Americans on
the
radio.
Hey, Joe.
Thank you, Joe.
I hope we live up to that.
How you doing, Jerry?
Super Dinah Whopping.
We met several years ago when you were doing a Bergen-Brunswick drug thing up in, you were doing the entertainment for them up in Washington, D.C.
Oh, yes.
And my mother's from Brookhaven, and I got an uncle that's still living in Bogachita.
Oh, lovely.
That was a pro brush thing, I think, is what it
yes.
was, basically.
Yeah.
Really enjoy hearing you, Jerry, and you've done a really great job.
Thank you, sir. Where do you live now?
I'm living in Peachtree City, just getting ready to move up to Marietta.
Okay, Marietta. Well, that's wonderful. Ludlow, Brookhaven, Mississippi, is the county seat of Lincoln County. It is the country of the Smiths. It's a small town, like 10,000,
mm-hmm.
but there's 36 full pages of Smiths. And you say, I'm from Brookhaven. My name is Smith. You a four penny or a six penny or an eight penny or a ten penny Smith? And it's not offensive to him. If he says, I'm an eight penny, you know he's from around Hikes Retreat. If he said, I'm a four penny, he comes from Arlington Community.
Oh, that's funny.
And the next most prevalent name is Case. If a Case and a Smith marries, they refer to their children as T tooties. And so Bogachitta, Mississippi. Hey.
They're Millers and Whites up there.
Well, Mokes around Bogachitta. You a good one, and we appreciate you lumping me and Ludlow as being great Americans. We try to be. I just had an old ship's reunion and went back and visited with my old buddies that I fought a war with, and I'm going to tell Ludlow about it a little later on, so stay tuned.
Well, we have had a chance to meet, and I'm looking forward to meeting Ludlow one of these days. I talked to Woody over the weekend,
yes.
Bloody. And
oh, did you?
Yeah, he had been on your show last week just for a minute and said that he was coming to town, so I gave him a call, and we missed each other over the weekend, but one of these days I hope to meet both of you guys.
Well, we're going to, Woody's going to be on with me October the 9th.
Yeah, he said sometime in October, and I hadn't picked up on that.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. I look forward to it, Joe.
Okay, we'll see you.
Okay, pal, take care of yourself. 872-0750. Here is Brenda on AM 750. Hello, Brenda.
Hi, Jerry.
Hey, Brenda.
How are you?
Wonderful, darling. How are you doing today?
I'm doing fine. I didn't have to wait nearly this long yesterday at 8 Stockton to get to talk to you.
Well, bless you.
Do you remember meeting the judge and his staff?
Oh, yes.
Judge Marion Pope from the Court of Appeals.
Hey, class.
You spent a long time talking with him.
Ludlow, I was just kind of loafing around and run into this southern gentleman, and his name was Pope, and he's a judge, an appeals court judge.
That's right.
And he's a fan of yours, and this lady's on his staff. It's on here now.
The lovely Brenda.
Yeah.
We enjoyed talking with you.
Well,
all
I enjoyed talking to him. He's my kind of people. If I ever had a decision, I'd just soon for him to read it and judge it fairly, because he's a good old boy. See, he ain't educated beyond his intelligence.
In all of y'all's conversation, I don't think that y'all reached the conclusion that both of your birthdays are tomorrow. Judge Pope's birthday is tomorrow also.
Oh, well, tell him I wish him happy birthday.
Well, he called. He's upstairs in a meeting right now.
Yeah.
And he obviously was very impressed with you yesterday also. So he calls down here to tell his staff that you're going to be on the radio at 10 o'clock and that we're allowed to turn the radio on and listen.
Well, isn't that wonderful? We done opened up the federal court.
My goodness.
Ain't that something? I tell you what Judge Pope did. I told him about my manager, Tandy Rice, who is affiliated also with Ludlow Porch. Tandy just married the most powerful woman in the state of Tennessee, and Judge Muriel Robinson, and now she's a Rice. And Judge had on a little gold gavel. I had a little handle and a gavel, and I said, Judge, get me one of them. I want to give it to... He just pulled that one off and gave it to me. So I got a little gold gavel. I'm fixing to send Muriel Robinson Rice, the judge in Nashville. Brenda, you are wonderful.
And now I've got to figure out where his gavel came from so I can order him another one.
Well, you can do it.
And I also wanted to tell you that when I went home yesterday and told my husband that I met Jerry Clower, he had a fit, and he said, if I'd have known he was down there, I would have met you at 8 Stockton and come down there to meet him himself.
Isn't
He's a big
something?
Fan. I told him it was a toss-up over who could tell the coon joke the best, you or the judge.
Well, the judge is a good one, Ludlow. He makes speeches around.
Well, we enjoyed meeting you.
Well, he was sharp, he was dressed nice, and he's got plenty of sense. For instance, Ludlow, something come up about a terrorist or something, and I said, well, I know a man in Harlingen, Texas, will kill him for $500. If I wasn't a Christian, I'd have him killed. Judge said, I know a man do it for
$200. Judge Pope's a good storyteller and a good, good joke teller. He likes to hear them and he likes to tell them.
Brenda?
So y'all hit it off and y'all got along great.
Thank you.
Brenda,
okay.
I want you to tell the judge for me that I appreciate him letting y'all listen today.
I sure will.
And he has to do it every day or I'm going to jump on him.
He's probably up there listening too. He's probably got the whole staff meeting up there listening to you.
You tell him we appreciate it.
Okay.
Thank you,
nice
my friend.
Talking to
Take
you.
Care of yourself.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 872-0750. I have to tell you about some special friends of mine now, and they are the folks at J&R Clothing. Now, let me tell you what these folks understand. They know that when you wear something bigger than a size 46, that you are just reaching adulthood. And they know that you should not have to pay 17 prices for big men's clothes. So they have name brand big men's clothes, brands you heard about all your life, and they are popular price. As a matter of fact, they're discounted 30%. So they got suits down there up to size 62 long, and I don't know where you can picture how big a 62 long suit is, but you could completely cover a Volkswagen Beetle with a 62 long suit. Marked down all the time, every time. These are good folks. You don't have to pay three prices for your big men's clothes. You stop by. They're clothes for the whole family, as a matter of fact. J&R Clothing. You're going to like these folks. Two locations on Highway 85 down in Riverdale. And still on Highway 85 down on the Fayette-Clayton County line. So you drop by and see them. They're good folks, and they will look after you. And, of course, alterations are always free. Now we have some good ones now, Jerry. Right behind you, we have the ladies and some gentlemen, too, from Happy Timers, Mount Gilead Baptist Church in Griffin, Georgia, and they are here visiting with us. We're glad y'all are here. Hope you enjoy yourselves. You come back and see
say
us.
Say Baptist Church?
Baptist Church.
Deepwater Baptist. Amen.
Good ones, good ones. Yeah. Let's check in now with our own meteorologist, Kirk Mellish.
Thank you, Ludmeister. Just more of the same right on into Sunday. A slight cool-off by Sunday, but no big deal. Highs in the 80s, lows in the 60s. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
My friend Paul Gonzalez, who will whoop a psychic on you in a heartbeat and do some kind of booger show. You listen to Paul. He's a good one. And Bizarre gives him the benefit of every doubt. He's a good old boy. Let's talk to Chip down in Covington. Chip, you're on with Jerry Clower.
Oh, Jerry Clower.
Hey, Chip, good morning.
How you doing?
Chip, you just blowed every tube on
Wonderful.
WSB Radio.
That's all right. That's you the best, Chip.
I got a question and a request.
All right.
What is your latest tape that you have out?
My latest tape is a 20th anniversary album on MCA, Rolling on the Mississippi. And it's been released about 5 weeks. And it's at the record stores. It's the 20th anniversary cassette tape.
Well, that sounds great. My request, I want a good coon hunting joke. I want to hang up and I want to listen to a good coon hunting joke. Everybody's waiting for a joke out here.
Well, the greatest coon dog that ever lived was Highball. Highball was known throughout the country, and people would come from afar just to hear him run. And one night, a world-famous surgeon came to Emmett County to hear Highball run, and Highball was turned out of the pickup, and it wasn't over 30 seconds. He was on a trail just whooping it. And, we was listening, and about that time, he shut up barking. And the doctor said, "What's the matter?" Uncle Percy said, "Hush, hush, hush, I think I know what's wrong. Hush, I think I know what's wrong." In about a minute, Highball started barking again. Just like he could see the coon. Uncle Percy said, "Just as I figured, Highball was running across posted land."
That's good. I haven't heard that one before. I thought I've heard all your jokes.
Oh, yeah.
Tell some more during the day.
Chip, come see us, buddy.
Nice talking to you.
Take care of yourself. 872-0750. Peggy, you're on with Jerry Clower. Peggy?
Hi, yeah.
How you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good.
How are things in Yazoo City?
Darling, things are wonderful. You know, Peggy, I live there for 34 years.
And I know you did, and I knew you before you became a humorist and made all that money.
Who are you, darling?
You know Jesse and Henry Hearn and Joy Sarton.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you told me once I sounded just like my mother and my sister.
Darling, if I could get a hold of you, me and Ludlow both would hug you.
Well, you know what? I yet it was down your way, but close to it when we went to the Southern Baptist Convention.
Yeah. Now, Mrs. Hearn is your mother?
That's right.
One of the most godly women I ever saw in my life, Ludlow.
Say that again, because you're right.
Oh, Ludlow, let me tell you. She's a godly lady. Her husband was very active in the First Baptist Church of Yazoo City and taught a Sunday school class, a retired chaplain from the Navy when he was 95 years old. And hurriedly, I must share this with Ludlow and the listeners.
We got about a minute.
I'm not trying to get anything started. But Mississippi College was going to bring their choir to the First Baptist Church of Yazoo City, Mississippi, about 20 years ago. They had one black out of 94. Some of our people forced it to a Sunday morning vote, and we ain't going to listen to them sing. Well, the morning we voted on it, Ms. Hearn, this lady's mama, got up and said, "Look, we going to sing in that angelic choir with them. Lord, we just as well sang with them here." And they took the vote, and that old godly woman got it passed. I appreciate you calling. You or something.
Yeah.
Peggy, I got to go. How long you been calling me? Because you got one of them.
Well, this is my first time to talk to you.
She's a Georgia dog. Married one of them dogs.
But I'm a Louisiana girl. I was born in New Orleans. I'm a transplanted
There's another lady who has been calling me for years, sounds just like you, and I was just curious.
Yeah, young blood.
You take care of your sweet self. Got to get out of here.
How long are you going to be here?
Talking to Jerry.
Oh, I'm going to do a show tonight for the Southern Company, but it's private, darling. They got me scattered around.
When are you going back to Macomb?
Oh, I'm going to get back down there tomorrow and go see Fats Domino.
I got to get out of here.
Hello, Josephine.
We're going to check the news and be right back. Stay with us.
Walk into New Orleans.
In the air, every morning and afternoon, Skycopter and Skyplane traffic on AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
WSB Atlanta.
AM 750 WSB, news time at the tone, 11 o'clock.
Good morning, I'm Mike Summers in the AM 750 WSB News Center. The temperature at 11 o'clock, 73 degrees. Today, blue sky, a little warmer, high about 85. The standoff involving a gunman holding hostages inside a Berkeley, California hotel bar is over. Police shot the gunman as he walked out of the bar this morning. Paramedics rushed the wounded man away as hostages ran into the street. During the night, police say the gunman killed one student and wounded at least seven other people. Crisis in the Gulf. Update. Iraqi officials say notes that were sent to foreign embassies and reported to be death threats have been misinterpreted. The notice sent to the U.S. mission was interpreted as saying the diplomats under law could be executed for hiding foreigners. President Bush has ordered the sale of 5 million barrels of crude oil from the nation's emergency stockpile. That move comes in an effort to put the brakes on rising oil prices. AM 750 WSB's Jamie Dupree says the decision will win support on Capitol Hill.
The president gets cautious support from local Democrat Ben Jones. Jones is one of many in Congress who would like to see conservation used, not the oil reserves.
Obviously, the president sees the need to do that, and if it does stabilize prices or bring prices down, then that's good.
Still, many feel the lessons of the 1970s have not been learned and that America is still slow when it comes to conservation. It's something Jones would like to see changed by Mr. Bush. In Washington, Jamie Dupree, AM 750, WSB News.
News of the president's decision has sent oil prices down in Great Britain. Iraq's trying another move in its effort to dissolve Kuwait's national identity. It's demanding that all Kuwaitis register as Iraqi citizens by October 31st. The French consul to Baghdad arrived today in Paris along with nine other French diplomats who were expelled from Iraq. The Senate Judiciary Committee is meeting at this hour, listening in live now. They're deciding the fate of Supreme Court nominee David Souter. It appears the nomination has already been decided, though 10 of the committee's 14 members say they'll support Souter. That vote is expected to come within the next 30 minutes. AM 750, WSB News Center time, 11:02. Just ahead, some help, 11:04. From the WSB Bell South Mobility Hotline, I-85 South at Union City exit, that's Highway 138. We have an accident reported with injuries on 75 South. Southbound between 166 and Cleveland Avenue, an injury accident. A new program pumps $270,000 into a Marietta neighborhood. Community Development Administrator Mitch Bland says low-income homeowners will get special loans to fix up their property.
They don't have to pay it back as long as they own the home for 5 years. It will be a rehab loan, but it's a forgivable loan. It will be forgiven in 5 years at the rate of 20% per year.
Bland says the rehab area will be near Lyman Homes in Marietta, North Page Street, bounded by Fairground, Hunt, and Pine. Fire has wiped out several businesses in downtown Lafayette, Georgia. Authorities say it started around 7:30 this morning in a Radio Shack store and spread to seven other businesses. No injuries reported. Fire departments from several counties are helping the crews battle the flames. Two Southern Pacific freight trains have collided head-on just east of Tucson, Arizona. Officials say five crew members were injured, at least two of them taken to Tucson area hospitals. None of the injuries is believed to be life-threatening. The time is 11:05. Here, triple the traffic coverage. The Bell South Mobility Network and Skycopter Skyplane reports. And when you see a problem, dial *750. It's a free call for Bell South Mobility customers. Now Atlanta's most accurate weather with WSB meteorologist Kirk Mellish.
My exclusive five-day forecast. Today, blue sky and warmer, high near 86. Tonight, clear and less cool, low 61. Sunshine and warm tomorrow, high 86, low 64. And the extended forecast Saturday and Sunday, partly cloudy, highs 81 to 85 and lows near 62. I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
WSB color radar is clear. Under sunny skies, the relative humidity is 63%. The wind is out of the east-northeast at 9 miles an hour, the barometer 30.11. And at 11:06, the temperature on Peachtree Street is 74 degrees. WSB talk show host Ludlow Porch is next. I'm Mike Summers, and if news breaks out, we'll break in. This is Atlanta's news, weather, and traffic station, AM 750. WSB. Depend on it.
The phone lines are open, and you can join the fun with Ludlow Porch on AM 750.
Some kind of beautiful day today. Hope you are enjoying it. Our special guest, one and only, Jerry Clower. And we hope you will jump in here and join us. 872-0750. 1-800-WSB-TALK. We're going to get right back to our phones and talk to Eula on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Eula.
Hi, Ludlow.
How you doing?
I wanted to speak to you and to Jerry.
Hey, Eula.
Hi.
Appreciate you hanging on to get to talk to us. You just must be a special person.
I'm Charles White's mother, and I believe you call him Biggin.
Say that again, darling.
I'm Charles White's mother.
Yeah.
And I believe you call him Biggin, don't you?
Oh, bless you. Ludlow Porch, Charles White, is your size and a world-famous Church of Christ preacher.
An adult preacher.
Yes, and I met him at Cleveland, Tennessee years ago, and he's a good old boy. He goes down into South America and has missions, and he isn't sophisticated to the extent that he wouldn't love a good old boy like you, and he's a preacher. Darling, you a good un for birthing Charles White. How's he doing?
He's doing fine. He just returned from Panama, and I wanted to tell you something I know that you will appreciate.
Yes.
He's trying to lose weight.
Yeah.
And, you know, the very thing that they lost going down there was all the food that he was supposed to eat.
Yeah.
And so he just had to
eat. Wonder where he throwed it. I buried it.
I guess he left it at the airport.
Well, yeah, he probably did, and then had to make a sacrifice to eat some of that baked goose and apple jelly after he got out
right,
there.
That's right.
That green apple jelly.
I remember you very well when you ate dinner with us that night when you were in Cleveland,
yes.
Tennessee.
Well, I remember him very well, and I thank you for birthing him. You know, I am the only deep water Baptist ever, Ludlow Porch, who has his name on the side of a building at David Lipscomb Church of Christ College. They gave me this bracelet, which I hold in front of you,
beautiful,
Ludlow.
Beautiful.
That's what they call an Egyptian cross. That's known as an onyx.
Uh-huh.
But I did a benefit for them, and they made $350,000. They challenged their people to pay higher prices for the tickets and made it. And Charles White, hey, that shows that regardless how hard-headed we are, if we are a child of God and believe we're supposed to love one another, we can get along. And me and old Charles White, we get along good. Thank you for calling so much.
Well, I wish
Charles White had been a twin.
I don't know if I could have stood that, Jerry.
You take care, Eula.
Well, thank you for talking to me.
We enjoyed it. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Sue, you're on AM 750 WSB with Jerry Clower.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This is Sue Womack from over at Orlando Wilson's office.
Ooh!
I understand that you've made a claim, and he's not here to defend himself.
Well, there ain't no defending. Everybody knows that Orlando Wilson was quoted in a satellite news magazine. They asked him, are any celebrities good fishermen? He said, Jerry Clower is a world-famous perch jerker. So he gave me that title himself. In fact, I want to thank him. Deercraft Boats has made a Jerry Clower perch jerking special. Oh, and then give me a little money to sit up in it and giggle and grin. But tell Orlando I ain't fished with him lately, and to call Sandy Rice and set it up. I want to be on a superstation.
All righty. Well, yeah. I can certainly take care of that. But I'm sure if he were here, that he would probably say that he may have made that statement, but there is no way that you could possibly be in his league.
Darling, he is the best bass fisherman, one of the greatest on earth. But he ain't no perch jerker. See, the thing that bothers me, and the perch jerking boat come up while I was on his show. Ludlow, if you see a boat commercial, they say bass fisherman.
Yeah.
Bass fisherman. There's more perch jerkers than there are bass fishermen, but they ain't never recognize us. We buy more boats than them. And I go fishing with Orlando Wilson, and he throws out there about three times. He said, we got to find them. Crank it up. And they go 300 miles an hour. You got to lay down in a boat. And I'm under more pressure than being on stage. But Orlando Wilson is one of the great ones. Tell him to call Nashville and line it up where I can go fishing with him.
I certainly will.
You know who got out of the boat and I got in the boat to tape the last Orlando Wilson fishing show I went on? Wade Boggs.
Huh.
That's right.
You tell Orlando if he wants to call here and defend himself, I'll talk to him.
Okay.
Well, he's headed over to the Kenny Rogers Classic. He's helping out over there with the fishing segment they've got.
I thought about Orlando when he was talking about big men sizes. You know, a lot of stores are just for runts, like Orlando. But big stores. What's that? That's J.R. who?
J.R. Clothing.
Yeah, I got to go see them.
Good luck.
I'm going to get the MCA record man to take me by there.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
You
take care of your sweet self. We enjoyed it.
Thank you. Well, let us wish you a happy birthday for tomorrow.
Thank you, darling.
All righty. Bye-bye.
We're going to talk to Delta Dawn on AM 750.
Delta Dawn.
Hello,
what's that
dear
flower you got on? Talk to us, Delta Dawn.
I am from Greenville. And I have friends that are connections in both of your Mississippi hometowns.
Yeah.
When I was growing up in Greenville,
Mississippi,
I did not have permission to call my parents' friends by their first names.
Yeah.
But one of them, somehow my sister and I got by with calling the wife by her maiden name and the husband by his surname. And she was from Liberty. Her name was Mary Elizabeth Frith.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know whether you would know her.
Oh, yeah, that's T's sister, T. Frith's sister.
Right.
Yeah, I remember that. We used to go to peanut ballings at their house.
Her. She's one of my favorite ladies. She lives in Greenville, and I just love her dearly. In fact, I called her on her birthday, and she said, this makes my birthday. This made me feel so good.
Well, that's fine.
And then my college roommate grew up in Yazoo City.
Yeah.
And I thought, what's the name of the street that goes down the middle of downtown, not downtown, but the is it Grand Boulevard?
Grand Avenue.
Okay, she lived on that. Her name was Hassan, and her father owned a piece goods store on Highway 49 as it went through Yazoo City.
On what kind of store?
Piece goods.
Oh, yeah.
I don't remember what his name was.
Yeah.
But I just wanted to call and sort of...
Well, I touch
home with two of my favorite people and let you know that we enjoy your tapes tremendously. And
I appreciate you calling, darling. Now, Highway 49, which
goes right through Yazoo City.
And it is Jerry Clower Boulevard.
Oh, that's right. It sure is. I've forgotten about that.
It is, and I appreciate them doing that. That was one of the real... memorable things about show business that I remember. You very kind. Keep listening.
Since it's Jerry Cutlower Boulevard, do you think you can pull some strings and get it four-laned all the way into... It's coming, but it sure is slow.
Well, it's four-lane through Yazoo City now.
Yeah.
And it's four-lane from Yazoo City down to Jackson.
Right.
Yeah, Jerry Clower Boulevard intercepts Medgar Evers Boulevard in Jackson. You the best. Keep listening to Ludlow.
Sure will.
How's King doing?
He's fine.
Good. You take care of yourself.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
About once a year, sometimes not quite that often, we have one of our annual wacko parties.
Yeah.
We invite all the wackos to come.
Good.
And the Delta Dawn met her husband at our wacko party, and they were married. And I said, at one wacko party, we had two marriages and one divorce at that one party, which I thought was pretty good.
Well, you 50% ahead.
It is 16 minutes after 11 o'clock. Our special guest is Jerry Clower. We'd like to have you join us.
you and get in for half price. There'll be arts and crafts, lots of food, entertainment, and more. It's fun for the whole family. You catch the free shuttle from the park and go on Camp Creek Parkway in East Point to the festival. This is Gerald McKee, and that's what's happening on AM 750 WSB.
Did you ever notice that the turkey you get at your deli sometimes tastes exactly like cardboard? There's a simple explanation for this. Some of it is made exactly like cardboard. They take miscellaneous turkey parts, starch, milk powder, and who knows what else, press it all together to look like turkey breast, and call it, oddly enough, turkey breast. At Boar's Head, we have a far less creative way to make turkey. Boar's Head turkey breast is made of turkey breast. How dull. No strange chemicals, no unspecified turkey parts, just turkey breast. Roasted the way you roast your Thanksgiving bird. Next time you talk turkey, talk Boar's Head. You'll gobble it up. Sorry about that, folks.
So the next time you go to your deli for fine deli products, make sure you get the best. Ask for Boar's Head.
Tom.
Yes.
When you hire new people for the Shane Company.
Yes.
What's the first thing you teach them?
How our guarantee works and the fact that there is value behind what we're selling. And basically that they'll never have a problem because of price when they make a sale. We will not be undersold.
You're not saying that you have them constantly discounting the price to make a sale.
Oh, no, just the opposite. What we explain to our people, and we encourage them to shop around for themselves so that they have confidence when they do wait on a customer, that the prices that we sell for every day are significantly below the retail jeweler's so-called sale prices. Remember, we won't be beat in price, and I guarantee it.
The Shane Company on Wendy Hill Road, the first exit north of the perimeter on I-75. Go west at Wendy Hill. Open Monday through Friday till 8, Saturday and Sunday till 5.
My son and I built a model plane together. We could hardly wait for its maiden flight. You should have seen Danny's face when I handed him the controls. Up it went. And it was going, going. I kept on going.
He called Citibank. Since he just bought the plane with the Citibank Visa, he was covered under buyer security.
The Citibank Visa replaced the kit for free. We had to start over again from scratch, but, you know, I really didn't mind.
It can be upsetting when something you've just bought is lost, stolen, or damaged, and even more so when that item is something special. But if you bought it with your Citibank Visa, you can get it replaced, free, with Citibank's buyer security. If you want service like this from your Visa, get a Citibank Visa. Look for an application in the mail or in selected magazines, stores, and restaurants. Not just Visa. Citibank Visa covers most purchases for 90 days from date of purchase against loss, theft, or damage. Certain conditions and exclusions apply.
It is 20 minutes after 11 o'clock. At AM 750 WSB, we're talking to Jerry Clower. If you'd like to talk to Jerry, questions or comments, 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK. Let's get back in here and talk to Jack. Jack, you're on with Jerry Clower.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Hey, good morning, Jack.
Jerry, in your playing days at Mississippi State, was y'all's little quarterback the one Frank Branch Jr.?
Twig Branch.
Uh-huh.
Twig Branch was there the year after I left.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Twig Branch went to Pearl River Junior College, transferred to Mississippi State, and Ludlow, he weighed 118 pounds, and he was all-state in football quarterback. And I remember him upsetting LSU playing a great game. He was little, but yes, I remember Twig Branch very well. He come by my house about 2 years ago.
One time when he come through the line and the big old Hampton, the big tackle there, George,
yes.
He just put his arm, just laid down with him. He didn't even tackle, he just laid down with
him.
Yeah. But I have to tell you a story, a true thing about a gentleman from the great Magnolia State.
Yes.
My squad leader, Sergeant Art Sell.
Mm-hmm.
Christmas of 1952, I told him, I said, I bet you I'll catch KP Christmas Day, and I got a 3-day pass. He said, if you do, I'll pull it. There my name appeared. Mm-hmm. We trot off down to see the first sergeant.
Yes.
First sergeant just raised cane. Oh, no, not none of my none come gonna pull no KP. He said, it ain't right. He said, well, I got a fatigue jacket with no stripes on it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna pull it for my man. He's in my squad. I'm gonna look out for him.
Yes.
He done that thing.
Mm-hmm.
I went on my 3-day pass in Germany.
Well, good.
Yeah. Fine gentleman.
Hey, well, that's fine. That's mm-hmm. good. I lost 11 pounds between them hedges.
Uh-huh.
I chased a Polish young man named Bratkowski.
Good old Zeke.
Georgia broke out a sophomore running back that day named Chio Daddy or Duo Duty, one of the two. And that was the runningest, slipperiest piece of runningest human flesh I ever saw. He'd stop and start and belly back. And one time he's gone for a touchdown, and he just turned around and run back through us just to humiliate us. Oh, I was playing left defensive tackle. You put your best lineman there.
Uh-huh.
Bratkowski took the ball, pivoted, pitched it to Chio Duty. He come around my side, and I knocked the tackle down. Got Chio Duty around the waist. I knew I had him for a loss because on that Mississippi State side, I could hear them cowbells ringing. And I went to sling him to the ground, and he slithered. Went straight up in the air like you squeeze a watermelon seed. I fell to the ground on my belly. Chio Duty come down in my back and just done a little dance, jumped off of me, commenced to running. Dog Owens, my teammate, said, "Jerry, get up and chase him." I said, "Lay still. He'll be back by here in a minute." Glad you called.
Okay, thank you, friend.
Take care.
Sure.
Sir.
Bye-bye.
872-0750. We're going to talk to Pat on a car phone. Hello, Pat.
I hope I can talk.
Hey, Pat.
Good morning to both of you.
How you doing?
I got to tell you a little story about Yazoo City, Jerry and Little O. Back in the late 60s, I had an argument with my wife, who used to be my wife,
mm-hmm.
and went out and got me a bottle and started driving. By the time I got to Yazoo City via Vicksburg, I was inebriated.
Mm-hmm.
There was an elderly policeman on the street in Yazoo City. There's a new bank there, and Yazoo City was new then.
Yes.
And I stopped at a red light, and he was looking at me, and I was looking at him, and he just spit the biggest old blob of tobacco juice on the sidewalk you ever saw in your life.
Yeah.
I put my car in park, jumped out with a beer in my hand, and run over, and I got all in his face. I said, "Man, don't you know it's against the law to spit on the sidewalk in Yazoo City?" He looked up at me. He says, "Sir?" I said, "I ought to call your chief right now and turn you in." Man, he got a handkerchief out of his hand, got down on his hands and knees, and started wiping that stuff up. I just got my car and drove off.
Yeah. You're a lucky man.
You are. Yeah.
That's a fine part of the country. Lived in Jackson, Mississippi for 14 years.
Well, Jerry,
I've been to Yazoo several times. That's a good part of the country, and the state of Mississippi, I'll be grateful you came from
there. Well, you're very kind. I hope when you get frustrated now, you don't reach for no bottle. You more stable now, ain't you?
I haven't had a drink 20 years.
You the best.
Yeah.
That's the way to do it.
Ludlow.
Yeah, man.
Good host, buddy.
Hang in there, buddy. See you soon.
Bye.
Appreciate you. We got some more of the Happy Times folks from Mount Gilead Baptist Church down in Spalding County in Griffin. We're glad to have you all with us.
Ain't that fine?
Turn around and look at those lovely folks, Jerry.
Hey, ain't they fine looking?
Good looking folks.
Yeah,
good
them looking. Storehouse tithers. That's why God's blessing them so. See, a lot of times you don't get because you don't give. Well, obviously some folks tithe in the income to the church down at Griffin.
We're going to talk to Bill down in Oakwood, Georgia. Bill, you're on WSB.
Hey, Bill.
Hello there, Jerry.
Hey.
This is old Bill Cochran, you know, raised over there on the other end of Route 4, Liberty, Mississippi.
What's your last name?
Bill Cochran.
Ooh. In the service, they call you, Yankees called y'all Cockerham.
There you go.
Yeah, Cockerham. Yeah.
Yeah, you know, my sister and all lives over in Liberty now and sees you all the time when you're around there on the street corners. And
yes.
I'm a Baptist preacher, been over here in Georgia for...
Oh.
About 25 years.
Well, that's great. You know, James Lester Cochran and Bobby Ed Cochran were raised out there at East Fork Community with me.
Right.
Bobby Ed still lives there. He got a big dairy. I take my granddaughters down there, and they play with his little baby calves.
Yeah, I think you went to school with my sister, Jessie Lane, married to Gordon Boy.
What you talking about? And Jessie Lane is kin to Jody Mae Anders that my brother married. You
right,
finna come on in there now. You kin to my brother's wife, Jody May. And you know that's a good Southern name.
There you go.
How long you been over here, Brother Cochran?
I've been over here about 25 years.
Beautiful. And you were?
I'm up here at Oakwood, Georgia, near Gainesville.
That's good.
I'm pastoring a church up here.
That's the way to do it.
Uh-huh. And I got a nephew who works at Blaylock's grocery store at Liberty.
Ooh, Goat Blaylock. Well, whenever you come home to visit some of your folks, you check with me. Folks know whether my car's out there at my house or not, and come by to see me.
All right. You know my brother Wallace, too.
Oh yeah, sure. Uh-huh. Yeah.
All right.
Preacher, thanks for calling.
Thank you.
Come see us. Bye-bye. Our number, 872-0750. If you're outside our toll-free dialing area anywhere in the United States, you can reach us and talk to Jerry Clow at 1-800-WSB-TALK. And for you Bell South Mobility customers, you can now call our talk shows on AM 750 WSB free. That's the talk number, 872-0750, and that is a free call on your Bell South Mobility phone.
If you don't have time to sit in front of the TV or can't stop to read the paper, try the talk shows on WSB Radio, an easy way to be informed and involved. Listen to Atlanta Talk on AM 750 WSB.
Strange things happen to people when they come to Acura Carland in Duluth.
Well, we thought this was strange.
Real strange.
We really did think the first thing we'd see would be some guy, you know, with bad hair and a blank staring girl petting a pit bull sitting on the hood of a car.
We were wrong.
Real wrong. Acura Carland has very normal salespeople. They're nice.
They give you straight answers.
Not double talk. They give you solid, fair prices.
And there's no one screaming, volume, volume, volume.
Oh, none of that great giggly wiggly stuff.
Oh, it's like a business deal.
It is.
You know you want an Acura.
Then you want to know where you'll get the best price.
Don't forget service.
Which you'll hardly ever need.
When you buy an Acura.
Exactly.
So go to Acura Carland.
Really? I mean, they can't come to you, so get a move on.
Now, a highly paid professional will tell you how to get there.
Take 85 to the Pleasant Hill exit and look for us on Satellite Boulevard behind Gwinnett Place Mall. Visit the Acura of Acura dealers. Acura Carland. Easy to find. Even easier to buy. Yeah, pretty strange. But don't worry. You'll get used to it.
And no pit bulls.
They get my fur up.
And smell.
Ask about Acura Carland's special closeout prices on all 90 model cars.
We've been dating close to 9, maybe 10 years in October, and I'm thinking, when are we going to make this official? And just the other day, he showed up at my front doorstep with his beautiful bouquet of flowers, and inside I'm saying, yes, yes, this has got to be it. And then 5 minutes later, we're sitting in front of the TV set watching ESPN. You know, it may not be one great leap for mankind, but it's a big step for him.
Florists turn feelings into flowers. The American Floral Marketing Council.
AM 750 WSB, Atlanta's leader for news, weather, traffic, a lot of other stuff. It's 11:30 with a quick update. Here's Mike Summers.
Good morning. Police in Berkeley, California say the deadly standoff at a residential hotel has ended. The remaining hostages have been freed. Police say they shot and wounded the gunman after he got close enough to a window at the Hotel Durant near the University of California campus. Iraq says it has no intention of killing Western diplomats who shelter their citizens. The foreign ministry says officials misinterpreted a note asking for a list of non-diplomats living in their compounds. The message also noted the penalty for hiding foreigners, though, is death. The agency insuring bank deposits will lose even more money this year than expected. William Seidman, chairman of the FDIC, reports that the fund assets will drop by $3 billion, $1 billion more than originally thought. Fire officials say a blaze that was apparently caused by an explosion destroyed one building in downtown Lafayette, Georgia, early today and damaged up to a half dozen others. Police have one suspect in custody, but they're looking for others in the shooting of an off-duty DeKalb County policewoman. Clementina Dillard is in serious but stable condition at Georgia Baptist Hospital with bullet wounds to the face and side. Police say an angry mob chased a suspected purse snatcher onto New York City subway tracks, where he fell against the 600-volt third rail and was killed. AM 750 WSB, the only station with our own helicopter and airplane. Depend on Skycopter, Skyplane traffic. Now Atlanta's most accurate weather with WSB meteorologist Kirk Mellish.
Saudi Arabia today, highs 101, lows 68. The WSB exclusive five-day forecast, bright blue sky and warmer today, high 85. Tonight clear and less cool, low 61. Tomorrow sunshine and warm, high 86, low 64. In the extended forecast for your weekend, partly cloudy, highs 81 to 85, lows near 64. I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
At 11:31, the temperature on Peachtree Street is 76 degrees. I'm Mike Summers, and if news breaks out, we'll break in. AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
Entertaining and unpredictable conversation continues with Ludlow. And you can join in on the fun by dialing 872-0750. Now, here's AM 750 WSB's Ludlow Porch.
All right, welcome back, gang. 11:32 now at AM 750 WSB Ludlow Porch, and our special guest, Jerry Clower. Let's get right back to our phone. We've got some folks been holding on since Jerry was in the Navy. Let's talk to Jim Clip. Jim, you're on with Jerry.
Hey, is that the tomato man?
This is the tomato man.
Jim.
How you doing?
Well, I'd love to slice one that'd cover a piece of light bread, just cover it,
yeah,
with some blue plate mayonnaise. You got any tomatoes?
Word is slather. Slather it on.
Slather it on.
Say, yay! Yeah.
How are your tomatoes holding up, Jim?
Fine, man, fine.
Mine are gone. I got one left, and I'm hoarding it.
Yeah.
I went by to see a gentleman yesterday, and he gave me about 10 off his vines out back, and his vines still loaded down.
Mm. Really? He ain't as far in the mountains as I am, because ain't nothing loaded down in that mountains, I guarantee you.
He lives on Fraser Road over here off La Vista.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, Jerry,
yeah,
the reason that we call Ludlow is we're frustrated entertainers. And he's got frustrated musicians, frustrated singers, frustrated jugglers. And I'm a frustrated comedian.
Yeah.
And what makes me frustrated is I have to steal material.
Well, we all do.
But when I steal from the best.
Yeah.
And I've got some of your stuff that I use quite frequently, and it's kind of worked its way into my everyday vocabulary.
Yeah.
Like, I wouldn't wear that to a respectable rat killing.
Right, well, we all steal from one another. Porter Wagner was telling me a story the other day. You know, the funniest things in the world actually happen. It ain't things that some creative mind may think up can happen. And Porter was touring with Grandpa Jones, and there's always a brand new Grandpa Jones story. When you go to Nashville, have you heard the latest wonderful old man. I love him. Porter was on the road with him, and they stopped at a rest stop. To go to a truck stop to go to the restroom. We all got back on the bus, and Grandpa's not there. Porter said, well, let me go check on him. And Porter went back and went back to the restroom, and Grandpa was still standing over there beside the wall. And Porter said, Grandpa, are you all right? He said, Porter, if I'd have known it's going to take this long, I'd have got a chair.
Jim, I got to tell you, in February, a lifelong dream of mine comes true. Let me tell you about this. Now, I'm being honored in February by the Big Heart people. I'm getting the Big Heart Award. And on the same podium at the same time, it's going to be me and Jerry Clower and Louis Grizzard.
Oh.
Now, hey. Louis has based an entire career stealing from me and from Jerry.
Yeah.
He ain't going to be able to say good evening, folks,
right,
that night.
Because
we're both going to be there watching him.
That's right.
I always wanted to stole the most.
Well, old Louis, bless his heart. How's he doing, Ludlow?
Louis doing fine. Wild as a March hare. Saw him the other day. We got to talk a minute. I got a great story to tell you, but it's got to be off the air.
me and Louis are a lot alike, with the exception that I've been happily married to a fine woman for 43 years, and I've always wanted old Louis to find him a lady what would love him, but...
He is still holding auditions.
Yeah, I understand. I want him to so conduct his life that that old transplanted pig valve will last him for 100 years. Is he behaving himself?
He's wearing him out faster than the pig does.
I may have to go get him in the throat.
You need to go.
I think I read he's going to have another one of those pig valves.
Yeah, he told me he dodged the bullet for the time being, but in a couple of years, sure enough.
Well, Louis, if you go back to the hospital and you remotely think you hear somebody say the word procto, don't you let them get you. You gather your split-tail gown around you, and you go hide in the nearest swamp.
Jim?
You got down there, Mr. Jerry, my coon dog, sir?
Yeah, can you do it in a minute and a half?
Yeah, I guess.
Oh, come on, Hoss.
You can do it.
All right. I had old coon dog named Mutt.
Yeah.
Mutt, he just wouldn't quit on the tree. If he ever got on the tree, then he's just going to stay there if somebody come to it.
Yes.
He got out down through one of the biggest swamps you ever saw in one night. Trees, you hear him for 2 miles, but there wasn't any way we'd get to him.
Yeah.
Now, we circled that swamp and tried to get in the other side and couldn't get in. Finally come daylight, and we couldn't hear him anymore and didn't have any bands to go by. We said, well, he'll come on that a while. He didn't come. About 6 months later, we was down there messing around that same swamp. Came up on the skeleton, leaned up on the tree, looking up.
Mercy. He was persistent, wasn't he?
He was that.
Well, them dogs that don't give up have some good ones. That's the same thing in life. Yeah. I was on a talk show the other day, Ludlow, and a guy called, said, Jerry, you've been the number one country comic in America 12 times. What is the most important ingredient that I'd need to be able to do it? Is it talent? I said, the United States of America is full of talented people who are miserable failures. It's persistence. It's got to want to do it. That alarm clock goes off. Get up! Determination, persistence. And that dog, coon dog, you got one that'll quit the trail and come walking up to the fire, they sell him right there. Or get rid of him. Persistence, determination. Ludlow Porch, number one in the market. Why? He ain't lazy. That's why he drives one of them pretty red Mercedes convertibles. Oh, you ought to get another. Get a black one, too. Oh!
You take care of your bad self.
Y'all be free.
I'll talk to you. Always a pleasure,
Jim. Send me a lug of tomatoes.
I'll do it.
Bye-bye. Well, we reached the time of the year now where you can bust a windshield with tomatoes now. We're about a month past the prime.
Well, yeah.
Y'all still got good ones in Mississippi?
Oh, no. The only tomatoes we get now is them greenhouse ones they ship, and they kind of pithy. You know, you bite into them, they ain't no juice. They'll never run off your chin.
Andy, you're on with Jerry Clower.
Hey, Mr. Fort.
How you doing, buddy?
Hey, Mr. Clower.
Hey, Andy.
Hey, I'm from Waycross, Georgia, and about a year ago, I was up in Calhoun, Georgia, and I was up there listening to you with Ray Stevens.
Yeah.
And you'd mentioned something about a fella named Broome.
Yeah.
From Waycross, Georgia. I was just wondering if I knew him or something.
Well, you ask Broome if he served on the USS Bennington CV-20. Because off the coast of Iwo Jima, I'm scared to death. I'm 17 years old, and an old boy named Broome from Waycross, Georgia, put his arm around me and said, Clower, don't worry about it. If they kill us, they can't eat us.
Well,
it's against the law.
my daddy was a Purple Heart veteran in World War II, and I didn't know what that guy's name really was.
I don't remember his first name. I can look it up in my book. I got a book that lists all the old sailors that I served with. And little old, I just went to this reunion, ship's reunion, and it started off on a Thursday night. They just get a little acquainted reception. They asked a fella, former chaplain, to pray. And he said, Lord, we thank you for this reunion. We thank you that we was able to live on the USS Bennington together. And Lord, you know we was willing to die together. And that kind of got to me.
Ooh.
I never had hay. I'd have dug up Ho Chi Minh and drug him down through the banquet hall, or grabbed Saddam Hussein in the throat and backhanded him if I could have got to him. But I got to thinking, the man answered my question, why are you so close?
That's right.
In the war, you got to get close if you're willing to die together. And you tell Ever Broome down there that I love him at Waycross, Georgia. That's old Miller's Cave, ain't it?
Yes, sir.
Did you know Waycross? And, Andy, I bet you know, Waycross is the largest town in the largest county in the largest state east of the Mississippi.
Yes, I knew that. And
they have an all-night gospel sing, too, in Waycross, Georgia.
Well, I come from a pretty big family, and you got a bunch of fans down there, so I just want to let you know that.
You take care of yourself, Andy.
Thank you.
Good to talk to you.
All right, bye-bye.
It is about 19 minutes now for 12 o'clock at AM 750 WSB.
Guess what time it is? It's the end of the year, which means it's time for your North Georgia Toyota dealer's year-end clearance. It's what everybody's waiting for.
And I'm glad I waited to buy a new Camry. Now I can get a great car and a great deal.
That's right. Camrys are on sale at the lowest prices of the year. Camry, the car J.D. Power & Associates initial quality survey calls the most trouble-free compact in America.
You know, reliability and a good price are always the two most important things I look for in a car. And I'll get both of those things when I buy a Corolla during
during the year-end clearance.
Save on the Toyota Corolla, the most trouble-free subcompact car in America.
I'm glad I waited until now to buy a new Toyota. I hear you can save hundreds.
You too can save on new Toyota Camrys and Corollas, not to mention Celicas and 2x and 4x trucks. Just visit your North Georgia Toyota dealers and see why our year-end clearance has people saying,
I love what you do for me.
Budweiser welcomes the New South Music Showcase, featuring the best new music in the southern region, to Atlanta, October 3rd through the 7th. Activities include concerts, seminars, workshops, and receptions. Concerts will be held at 12 venues in Atlanta, featuring rock, pop, rhythm and blues, folk and urban. The other activities at Colony Square Hotel. To charge by phone, call Ticketmaster, 249-6400. Or for information, call the New South Hotline, 875-5579. Music fans, nothing beats the New South Music Showcase, and nothing beats a club.
Nothing beats it.
There's something new for you in the Atlanta Journal-Constitution.
So little time, so much to do. Today's paper makes it easy for you. On the run, take the turn. Turn the page and have a look inside. Today's paper, here for you. Always something fresh, something new. Today's paper, yeah.
We know how your life is. You've never had more to do or less time to get it done. Today's Journal Constitution is designed for you. You'll find lively, concise reporting on the issues that affect you most, from health care to family and children to the environment. The new Atlanta Journal Constitution, just right for the way you live today.
Carswell intercepted on the 33. Carswell fell down in the 40. Carswell intercepted. Carswell saved our Franny. And the Dogs will have the ball on the 40.
This is Larry Munson. Follow Georgia football exclusively here on WSB. This Saturday, Georgia plays East Carolina University. Tailgates at 10:30. Kickoff is at 1 o'clock. Follow the Dogs on AM 750 WSB.
All right, 11:44 at AM 750 WSB. Ludlow Porch and my special guest, the one and only Jerry Clower. Let's get right back to our phones and talk to Bill. Bill, you've been waiting a long time. We thank you for your patience, old friend.
Good morning, gentlemen. I've been waiting so long, I got 5 o'clock shadow before noon.
Listen, hey, Bill. We appreciate it.
Jerry, I see you every March, and I assume I'll see you next March in, I believe it's Nashville. You'll be there, won't you?
The Southeastern Conference Basketball Tournament.
Absolutely.
It may be the first one that I'll miss since they started back. I did the Strawberry Festival last year, March the 9th, at Plant City, Florida. And I got home, believe it or not, and there was a notice that I'm booked back at the Strawberry Festival. That's one of the most prestigious shows in the world. I mean, they seat like 20,000 folks, and I did it with Brenda Lee. Well, I never thought nothing about it. Hey, usually my manager don't book me that far ahead. But when I sent in my notice to my manager, block off the Southeastern Conference dates for the basketball tournament, he said, well, the Strawberry Festival got him first. And that's on a Saturday. And I'd rather go up and drag around. I may miss this one in Nashville. I may come to some of it. But you go and represent me.
It won't be the same, I'll tell you.
Well, and if I'm going to miss one, Nashville's the place, because there's so many folks would be pulling at me and want to interview and all this. But I'm anxious to get Arkansas and South Carolina into that SEC tournament. Well, you know why the chicken crossed the road?
No, not your story, no.
To join the ACC.
My next question was going to be what you thought of the new lineup.
I think it's wonderful. I think it's good. Us Southeastern Conference folks ain't never had it so good. And to see the athletic director at the University of South Carolina, on national television. I'm telling you, I've never seen a man more sincere about getting into a conference in my life. I really didn't know what the Olympics meant to Atlanta until they interviewed my friend Vince Dooley at the announcement, and Vince was crying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, here's my macho hero. Mad to my main groupie girlfriend, Barbara Dooley. She chases my bus. Oh, she loves
me. I live in Georgia now, and I go up there and root for Georgia or wherever the tournament
but,
is.
But here's Vince Dooley was so emotional. He was so proud. I told my wife, I said, honey, the Olympic Games means a lot to Atlanta, Georgia. If Vince Dooley cries with joy, God bless you, Barbara, wherever you are. Oh.
My true allegiance is still with my home state, though. And let me warn you people, you better take advantage of this SEC basketball while you can.
Where's your home state?
My guys will be back next year.
Where's that?
Kentucky.
Oh, yeah, well, no. No, they're not eligible next year. They'll be eligible in Birmingham.
Well, I mean, year after next.
Yeah, that's right.
In fact, I have in my possession a cap with a big K on the front of it. It says Official Sutton Supporter. Do you think I ought to throw that away?
I ought to throw it in a trash can.
I think maybe I ought to keep it for a collector's item.
No, my preacher is a big Kentucky fan. He thinks when he dies, he's going to Rupp Arena.
Let me tell you a real quick story.
All right.
There is a professor at George Washington University who does a motivational tape called Abilene Paradox. Did you ever hear of it?
No, sir.
Well, it doesn't matter anyway. I wanted to get a copy of it, and I couldn't find one around here anywhere, so I called one of my Yankee friends and asked him if he could get it for me. He said, yeah, I can get it for you, but I'll only send it to you if you'll send me 2 Jerry Clower tapes. And I said, what do you mean? 2 Jerry Clower tapes ought to be at least 3 of those professors. So we argued back and forth and finally decided to swap one-on-one.
Well, yeah.
He sent me the tape, and I sent him the Jerry Clower tape that he couldn't find in Yankee Land.
Well, where was he?
Well, he was in Washington, D.C., but I think he was up around Iowa someplace.
He pulled your leg. I sell more albums in Baltimore and Washington, D.C. than I do Waycross.
Well, maybe he just
he was pulling your leg. MCA record executive sitting right here shaking his head. But listen, the press and the media show more partiality to Kentucky and Notre Dame than they ought to. And that's kind of so. And every now and then I think the referees lean toward them. But that's another show at another date. Take it over, Ludlow.
Come see us, my man.
Pleasure talking to you.
Okay, old friend. Take care. It is 11:49. Here's Kirk Manish.
Beautiful again today, Ludlow, a high around 85, sunshine and warm again tomorrow, a high around 86, lows around 62. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
Now that the kids are back in school, now that everyone's back from vacation, you may think summer's over.
Well, it's not over until the summer thunder closeouts at Bellamy Walker's Chevrolet Geo. You've heard about incredible rebates, unbelievable financing, super discounts, prices slashed. Well, the sales manager at Bellamy Walker has heard about them too. And he's told me to tell you that during the summer thunder closeout, going on right now at Bellamy Walker's Chevrolet Geo, no other car dealership can offer you a better deal on 4 wheels. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'll repeat that because I do have the time. No other car dealership can offer you a better deal on a new or used car, truck, or van. So take the Bellamy Walker Challenge. Come on down I-75 right now, just past the airport to Bellamy Walker's Chevrolet Geo. Exit 69 at McDonough. Just say, I want the best deal on 4 wheels at the heart of Georgia Chevy Geo dealers. Bellamy Walker's Chevrolet Geo.
I'm talking to Sylvia Richardson of Marietta, an ex-smoker thanks to Stop Smoking Clinics of America. Sylvia, did you try other methods?
I've smoked for 25 years on an average of a pack a day. I tried everything. I tried, let's see, Nicorette gum. I tried cigarettes, acupuncture.
Really?
Cold turkey.
Then you went to Stop Smoking Clinics?
I was skeptical because, like I said, I had tried so many things, but it worked.
Good.
I feel a lot better. I even look better. My husband told me.
Well, what was the difference from other methods?
It was easy. There was no withdrawal.
All right. Thanks, Sylvia.
No problem.
At Stop Smoking Clinics of America, licensed medical doctors supervise a simple, proven treatment that safely blocks nicotine withdrawal symptoms. Already, it's helped over 1,000 Atlantans quit. And the treatment is even covered by most insurance. Call Stop Smoking Clinics of America at 513-STOP. That's 513-STOP.
I don't even think about smoking anymore.
backers are close, acting like they're coming in. Miller back. They're coming after him. Miller going to throw a long bomb. Long bomb. Touchdown!
Stand up with your hometown team. Stand up with the new Back in Black high-flying Atlanta Falcons. A word of caution, however, don't plan on sitting down. In the Falcons' backyard each Sunday, you'll see NFL excitement at its best. You can count on being out of your seat, cheering and enjoying Falcon football.
By the 40, my God, Deion Sanders is going to score! My God!
Don't be left out of all this fun and madness. Join the Falcons in their stand against some of the best in the NFL. Because the Falcons' backyard will be full for many games, you should order your tickets today. So come on, Atlanta, let's stand up together this season at the stadium. Call now, 249-6400, or stop by one of the convenient Ticketmaster Center locations.
You've got to get this thing.
You've got to get this thing.
You've got to get this thing.
Prodigy, it's the online service that connects you and your computer to the rest of the world.
Prodigy makes your PC a powerful tool.
You wouldn't believe the number of uses that it has.
I do my shopping at home. I can get groceries.
I don't have to wait in the lines anymore.
I can use it to buy and sell stocks.
I get the latest sports while the game's in progress.
It's got this educational game that teaches kids geography.
And now they've even added an encyclopedia.
Prodigy now has a great new feature, a 21-volume electronic encyclopedia that never goes out of date.
I like that part.
And boy, does it help me with my homework.
The kids are having fun and they're learning.
I'll tell you, it's terrific.
Oh, it's so easy to work.
Connect Prodigy to your computer and your phone, and you're connected to news, shopping, banking, and now an electronic encyclopedia. All this and more for only $12.95 a month. Just buy the little yellow box that gets you started on the Prodigy service at a dealer near you.
You don't have to be a genius, but it sure makes you feel like one.
You just gotta get this thing.
Bank fees may apply.
Hi, this is Bobby Harper on the Friday edition of Atlanta's Morning Show. Conversations with coaches Glanville and Goff. We'll also say happy birthday to Larry Munson. We'll talk to Dave from Conyers, Ken Stein, our Mideast expert, and we'll say happy birthday to Hartsfield International Airport, every square inch of it. Join us tomorrow morning. And now, more with Ludlow Porch on AM 750 WSB.
All right, we've got 5 or 6 minutes here left with my friend Jerry Clower. And we're going to get right to our phone, because we got some folks been holding on here forever, like Helen. Helen, talk fast, lady. How you doing?
Fine. How are you, Ludlow?
Good.
I want to tell you how much I'm enjoying listening to Mr. Clower.
Hey, Helen.
Listen, I want to tell you, Mr. Clower,
yeah.
I'm a relatively new fan of yours.
Yes.
But my husband introduced me to your tapes, and I think you're the funniest man alive.
Well, thank you.
I just enjoy it to no end.
Thank you so much.
But listen, when are you going to be doing a public concert in Atlanta?
Darling, this is a private thing tonight. I do Lanier Land every year, and I just got through doing that. But I may not be in this area the rest of this year, but I will be coming back in, like, September. I go to Hattiesburg, Baton Rouge, Orangeburg, South Carolina, Red Bay, Alabama, Gulfport, Louisville, Kentucky. How far is Perry, Georgia, from here?
Just Perry's right. Below Macon, about
nice
40
little drive
miles below Macon.
Yeah.
It's
above Macon, isn't it?
No.
No,
it's kind of off to the right and south.
Oh, yeah. Is it? Well, how far are you?